the Githyanki would call this an Ormalar, an alliance of M'lar.
And what is a M'lar, exactly?
Builders, craftspeople, and the makers of the incomparable silver swords the Githraki wield in battle. The M'lar may not be warriors, but they are no less valuable to my people.
Oh, cursed to put my hands on everything. Inside. Always room for more?
Poor fucker.
That matters.
Ah!
hostage for peace.
There must be another way through.
I'll give it a shot. Come on, open up.
Is that blood on the shelves? Probably cold and congealed. Oof. Quite the list of characters, but hardly my taste.
Get going.
Blackets will be done. Onward.
Let's march! Hey!
Is that blood? No, never mind. Never wanted the easy path.
On foot!
trouble now.
I'd love to, thanks. On my way.
A long road ahead. Breathe deep and move.
Find a spot for an ambush.
I won't give in.
Let's cut your fire, baby.
Death.
watching me.
Gone fishing. Catch you later, Ellis.
Hope this ends well. Seems simple enough.
Here lies Largo Krivens the Younger, taken along with his family on the same grim night. May their deaths be avenged.
Impressive. Last I saw this child, she was cowed to Korga's snake.
Sorry. It knocks the wind right out of me. one. I learnt it all on my own. Well, I had a little help. That druid idol I took? It changed me. I can do all sorts of stuff now, not just the vines. I think real hard and say some loud words and then it happens, mostly. If I get strong enough, I won't have to run next time. Okay, I promise to be really good with practicing, but only if you look for Mum and Pops. Deal? Thanks, mister. I knew you'd help me again. The vines won't last forever. I don't suppose I can stay with you. Just till you find Mum and Pops. I won't be any trouble, I swear it. Oh, thanks. You're the best. So you send Mum and Pops there. I'll be waiting, hero man.
Grandmother, and the child will bear her name. Maldred, you sense a swell of grief. Before the shadows took her, this woman mourned someone lost in battle.
I'll take that.
The doctor is absent today. Come back another time.
The doctor's found oblivion. Well, no time to mourn. I'll fix this without him. Still not feeling better. Let's see if I can help you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got to tend to my patient.
Something good here, I hope.
What a day.
Can't give up now. Word.
Hey, you. I made it. Easy peasy. You find Mum and Pops? No. No, no, no. I don't believe you. It isn't true. It isn't. Get away from me. Go. Leave me alone! I don't believe it. They can't be.
Breathe, child. Resist not the winds of change. Let them carry thee.
No. No!
Listen. Dost thou not hear it? Where creation meets ruin, where morning meets midnight, the root of all being. Balance.
They're dead! I can't! Balance.
Your very soul is tangled in shadow. Arabella's magic, wild as cursed briar. Her talent is now yours, too.
The girl must learn the ways of the arcane. But she shan't remain here. Arabella holds a power beyond reckoning. That of the decaying forest and the seedling that bore it. But it is unbalanced. Her yoke is already heavy. If she walks thy path, it will surely break. Arabella will depart once thou dost leave these accursed lands. She will find her way safely. Thus, it is fated.
Bowman, you're making me leave.
Fear not, girl. The Weave knows thy purpose. It will guide thee. If thou dost listen.
Thou must.
I...
You feel the grief fade as if it were your own. There is a lightness in her now, veiling the power within, soothing it.
Is that my future? Is that why they died?
It is.
It's wonderful. Thank you, Bowman, for being nice. If there are people like you around, perhaps everything will be all right. If Bowman says I'll be all right, I'll be all right. I wish it was different. I wish Mom and Pops was here. I don't feel so strong. Or anything, really. Just tired.
Thou walkest alone. On all these harsh nights, thou hast sought no company. Love is no domain of mine. But it is often cited as the purpose of mortal life. Wherefore turnst thou from it? And thus thou art alone.
To put my hands on everything. What's in here?
Catherick Thorne's ancestors, desecrated and arranged into foul artworks. But why? The answer lies in darkness.
Step carefully. There's a trap.
Well, hello. Easy. Don't linger. All right.
In darkness, beauty is equal and wealth unseen.
I can't slow down. Well, so much for peace.
Keep your distance, darling.
All right. What now? More for me?
Unworthy. Unworthy to walk among friendly bones. Leave! Talking of you, intruder, invader, unworthy one. These halls are not for you.
A miserable shiver runs down your spine. You feel as if you've unburdened a troubling thought and forgotten it forever.
Better not be cursed.
Feed your bodies and rest your minds. Lady Shah needs her warriors strong and ready.
You prowl my battleground. Why? Are you friend, foe, thieving scavenger?
Find yourself in a dead, putrid skull, somehow hosting a tadpole amongst a squirm of maggots. Another presence lurks within, manipulating the corpse like a puppet.
Ah, a friend. An uninvited friend. I do not request help. Come join me and find out. I want to look at you with my own eyes. of the shadows. They found me.
you for this.
I will ascend.
Nothing will stand in my way. Keep your heart in your chest. those. Still breathing, despite everything.
Enough sitting around. Let's go hurt someone.
Battle.
Should mind my step. Find a way forward. Let's see what this does. Thank you.
Enough waiting. I crave blood. Proceeding. Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood. Quickly then.
Have a lot on my mind and, well, in it.
There's something out there. I can feel it.
Turn someone inside out.
Time for a new approach.
Now.
Form up ranks! Don't let anything get past you! See how many pieces can be blasted off you before you die!
Tremble!
to kill you! Ah, bravo! That almost stung!
well that ends...
Not as bad as it could have. What path lies before me?
Some rest is better than none.
Have to keep going. Very well.
We outnumber you. Leave me be. Unworthy of dark cloak. Unworthy of dark fur. Unworthy.
Strange little beast. I would have made short work of it once.
The rat isn't merely territorial, it's proud. This place means a great deal to it. The rat holds its ground. It almost seems defiant.
We've always been here. It's ours. We watch over it. You do not belong.
A rat with delusions of grandeur. A bit like the gods themselves.
Leave. Away. My nest. My dark.
So much blood. What the hell's has been happening here? A bed made of corpses. Disgusting. And uncomfortable. That'll fit in my pack.
Halsin's proved himself a fine ally already. He'll be useful in battle, if those tree trunk arms are an indication.
Halsin is one hench elf. I'm impressed, and glad he's on our side. Sad. I couldn't let myself feel sad in the Hells. Letting my guard down would have been a death sentence. And letting, say, a Cambion near me would have been disastrous. I thought it best just to keep my distance. But loneliness that deep gets into the marrow. Now that I'm here, among friends, I can feel it burning out of me. Little by little. Step by step.
Hello, my dear.
The Orphon is nothing. I'll have my satisfaction when Raphael makes good on his word. Thank you for helping me. It was very kind.
very gory idea of art.
Someone's left a trap out for us.
Do you know what happens when a devil is struck down on this charming plane of existence? It returns to the hell. To the very point where it last stood before venturing to whichever devil-forsaken plane it died on. In the case of our friend Jurgir, the Orthon you so handily dispatched in the Temple of Shah, he manifested in my House of Hope. He returned to me chastened but intact. His wounds healed, his body restored. He thought I would dismember him. But he has his uses, so instead, I am re-educating him.
We delivered the devil. Now I want what I'm owed. We had a deal.
Indeed we did. I discovered all there is to know about those scars of yours. It's a rather grim tale, even for my tastes. As you wish. Brace yourself, Astarion. We're about to unveil your destiny. Carved into that ivory skin of yours is one part of an infernal contract between the archdevil Mephistopheles and your former master, Cazador Zar. In full, the contract states that Cazador will be granted knowledge of an infernal ritual so vile it has never been performed. The rite of profane ascension. It promises to be a marvelous ceremony, very elaborate, incredibly ancient, and entirely diabolical. If he completes the rite, he will become a new kind of being. The Vampire Ascendant. All the strengths of his vampiric form will be amplified, and alongside them he will enjoy the luxuries of the living. The arousals and appetites of man will return to him, and unlike Astarion, he will have no need of a parasite to protect him from the sun. But the ritual has its price, as all worthwhile things do. Lord Cazador will need to sacrifice a number of souls, including all of his vampiric spawn, if he is to ascend. Imagine how he felt then, when one of those precious spawn simply disappeared into thin air. The only missing ingredient is Astarion. You are the final piece he requires to complete the ritual. Your scars. powers. Bind you to it. Your soul will set off a very wave of death, bringing Cazador his twisted life. And that, my tragic and toothsome friend, is that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have business elsewhere.
Do you think it's so simple? The idea definitely has appeal. I could get rid of the worm in my head and still walk in the sun. I'd finally be free of the hunger. And if I'm the key to this deal of Cazador's, perhaps I can turn this to my advantage. I need to take the fight to him, and I need you to help me. Thank you.
I can't imagine how Astarion must be feeling. The terms of your own condemnation carved into your skin. Monsters' actions. And monsters do not deserve such power as that ritual promised. When the time comes, Astarion will have his revenge, I'm sure. And it will be richly deserved. But not yet. So, what can I do for you?
The dog is unable to speak through the small bag he holds in his...
I don't know. Maybe you can tell. All I know is I thought of you when I saw it.
It seems like Cazador used Astarion's flesh not as a canvas, but as a contract. We haven't heard the last of this, I'll wager.
Our very own vampire is the missing pawn in his master's deadly game. Now, how about we go and reverse Cazador's fortunes?
Oakfather preserve you. Honestly, I never thought I'd make it that far. But the Absolute is a threat to all, and I promised I'd help you with your parasite. So, I'll remain with you. If you'll have me, that is. Well, I can only hope I don't disappoint.
Druids and harpers joined together to put a stop to Ketherick Thorm. We marched on Moonrise, and after much fighting, we prevailed. Even in defeat, though, Ketherick turned to Shah. Not long after we sealed him away in his tomb, the Shadow Curse took hold. No one had seen the likes of it before. No one knew how to react. Then it started to claim all those within its reach. Those who had survived the battles now fell to the shadows, became part of the shadows. And worst of all, I lost contact with Thaniel. I wanted to try and find him, but we couldn't stay. We would have all succumbed. When the Archdruid of the Grove, my predecessor, was seized by the curse, I had to lead the survivors to safety. That was my first day as Archdruid. An inauspicious beginning. You are right, but I must not lose focus until everything has been put right. I've wasted too much time already. Years in which nature has suffered. only by a reputation. She was present when we marched against Ketherick Thorm, but on the far end of the battle lines from where I fought. And in the chaos that ensued, well, our forces were scattered. I led some to safety, but never learned of her fate. I'm glad to hear she survived. Though in truth, I should not be surprised. She was always said to be formidable and cunning. I could have learned much from her, no doubt. There is much to admire, judging by the stories. I cannot help but wonder how she would have handled some of the challenges I faced as Archdruid. Would she have helped the refugees? Defended the Grove? Controlled Korga? At least now we can benefit from her presence, and perhaps work to a common goal.